Would you say there ain't no way that you leave it out, and if you leave it there, ain't no way that she does. You leave it there, and not only will she do it, your mate's on the victim of 4 or 5, she's falling. And it happens over and over and over. If he ever gets up on you, it's just awful. Yeah, he's just making a difference. She can't leave him nothing. Nothing. You got freezing hot ball.
Don't say that.
I said, what were we supposed to do? Slap it out of her hand or down tackle? I said, you want to call the down tackle?
That's what we did.
We determined that ordinance says that after 11 o'clock, which y'all are a bar now, we're not a restaurant. We got a restaurant entertainment license. He comes up and says, we determined on that ordinance, me and my boss man, that y'all now are at 11 o'clock, y'all become a bar. No one under 21 can go in. You had to have somebody at the door card. And you got to have a legal bouncer. To make sure I didn't have any DUIs or no charges. If you got a DUI or a charge against you, you can't be a bouncer. So we ain't got nobody to talk about. Me and Marcus. So, and then he comes in and tells us that, and I wanted to say, well, here, I know you're a policeman, you've got to do your job. But your job ain't to interpret what the public says. Better go get your damn city attorney to interpret it and tell you what it says. Because you ain't. You got the right to write me a ticket if I break a law. You do not have the right to interpret the law and tell me to do this. That's what I remember. I ain't gonna do it until
we open up a place like this, right?
That was a Longhorn, the bowling alley. It's over here at the bowling alley. So now at 11 o'clock, they can allow a teenager to go in there and bowl. Because they serve alcohol. And it's because they interpreted the law like that. They didn't say that's what the law is. They didn't say that that's the ordinance said that. They said we interpreted it the same way.
Trying to figure out how to change that car. No, sir, I gave up on that. I was just going to start putting a score on the thing. I was just going to start putting a score on the thing.
So how do you do it if you can't see it?
It's the most.
I'm waiting for a real one.
Is that for you or for him? Do you have an address you have
that? I'll probably end up with it. He's going to run my head, get it good. If he don't pay me back for it, this will be mine. But if he does, it'll be his.
If
you win this match, you'll probably pay me back. If you don't, it'll be mine.
And they go to the main store and do something. It's a good old boy. But now they put the hardship on me, and I ain't never heard any law. And when I told him, I said, you know, this alcohol is
I wish I could read like you know, like that. I get tired of reading. I tell them, just tell me the cliff notes. So,
So how far is y'all play from there?
Is that how it's set up now? It just shows a row of the big tables and a row of small tables. That's just a picture that pops up. It's the first time he's put that on there. So that was a match earlier. We didn't put the score earlier. Yeah, just like that. He added the score. So we had to see. Don't say that.
Yeah. probably lose the first match. They told us, well, they come over there the first time, he had a deck out there, and they came to us, black girl, they went the deck, across the parking lot, in between the door, in the car, and he's seen it. He comes out there, checks his ID, he's underage, then he comes in there and gives us a warning. I said, what were we supposed to do? Slap it out of our hand or down tackle? I said, you want to call the down tackle?
That's what we did.
He comes up and says, we determined on that ordinance, me and my boss man, that y'all now are at 11 o'clock, y'all become a bar. No one under 21 can go in. You have to have somebody at the door calling. And you got to have a legal bouncer.
I think we bartended years ago. I mean, we just, everybody had one beer at the end of the shift. You know, we didn't make it, didn't break nothing up.
In Tennessee, if you work in a bar, you cannot even drink it anymore. Yeah. Off duty, you can't drink it. You got to go to some other.
I mean, I guess the owners would like that. I mean, I help you and everybody to bartenders helping friends drink. I mean, I guess that's a plus.
That's why they do it. I mean, that ain't got nothing to do with the state. The state can give a damn thing to prove. But they also, that's they tax their liquor by how many bottles you buy. They determine that you can mix 24 drinks out of that bottle, and you get taxed for 24 drinks. Whether you pour it down the drain or whatever, you get taxed for it. Bye.
That's funny that law would supersede the state. That's like, you know, we go to the beach a lot, helmet law, Carolina helmet law, down the beach. They were trying to stop you. You had to wear a helmet inside the city limits. Because they really wanted to ban it. Like, you can't understand it that way. But to hurt one, you had to hurt them all. So they put a law in that you had to wear your helmet inside the city limits. But the minute you got out, you could take it off. State law supersedes inside the city. And there was attorneys all over the place just saying, if you get a ticket, everything's free. Just take it and we'll fight it all. That's just stupid. I mean, everywhere there were signs. No calls if you get a ticket.
Well, they're requiring us to have bouncers. We hadn't had a fight. Well, we probably hadn't had since we've been over the five and a half years. Most of the time, our girl,
So don't think about it yet.
You got him first and the next one, you got him, and the third and the fourth one are up, you got him too. Yeah, I almost had to go to the hospital. He got
in
the car later.
Let me tell you, this was, I think it was
actually cool. I think it was really his fault.
Masters Week last year, this may be the funniest thing I've ever seen. I don't know if you've ever been to the country club here in Florida. Masters Week is definitely insane. I'm talking about, I don't know how they get past 500 people in the membership all over the world. There was a little strong and cool guy. I'm talking about height wise, like Tony. Tony was playing here. I'm talking about he was stuck, so he was solid. Somebody bumped into him. He just walked by. You know, and the guy brushed off, but the drunk bounced off to it. But this guy's got nothing wrong. He's there like the other drunk.
Yes, sir.
The guy drunk was all the way to the at this point, for a short time, he put it in the Google video. I don't know if it's apparently, he looked like a light heavyweight MMA fighter, world champion or something. He gave him a chance, and so all the friends were dragging and drug him off. That little dude was about to kill him. I mean, but it was just funny for him to tell him, I'm going to give you 2 minutes to go before I take you to your ass. I've never laughed so hard in my life. I nearly fell out. I don't think I've ever laughed so hard in my life. I didn't know that. I never heard of it. I mean, he was short. I mean, he was solid. I mean, he was 100% solid.
Motorcycle game we had, I mean, it was the same. I got several more of them.
Always at the end. So the cursor is behind the three right now. And if I wanted to change Billy's score, you use the home button to function and left, and it goes all the way
to the far left.
To the far left. Name. So it's in front of the one. So then you can hit the delete button.
Oh, so you put the score in front. Okay, I got you.
Right, that way I can do the backspace, or if I do that, then we're all the way over there.
Good. We have had some things.
So you're close to Savannah? How far are you from Savannah? Do you know, I'm sad to say I know, Billy Simon. He messaged me the other day, he said he was going to go down there and get his boots somewhere close here or something. I know his mother or grandmother lives in Georgia. I remember that years ago. Like, he'll message me at 1 o'clock in the morning. At least that's supposed to be me, but I haven't seen him. You talk about it a little while.
He has changed a lot.
Is it? Okay. He's been a long time.
He's still being so. He's still running out, but he's learned now instead of insulting so bad, he makes a joke out of it.
So I thought that makes it better.
That way he don't get his ass beat all the time.
Now, he had the potential to play good. I knew Billy when he was running around with Tony Allen.
He was worse than 10. There's
no way.
He made every single time. In fact, one of my cartoons, I said, Mary, And they went back into, I'm talking about, I finally, we were playing, he told me one play one time. Center ball shooter. Hey, I'm talking about, he can shoot center ball better than anybody ever and get where he needs to get. And we were playing nine ball one day. In here, there's a couple of people in the locker room. And I was beating class. I walked over to the table side of it. And he shoot a shot. And I pulled his feet and cue balls on the table. And I bumped my cue balls to the other end just let him go over back to mine. And I hit the ball hard enough. And then I stopped and I went over to shoot the ball. He shoot the ball. While he was walking around the table looking at him. Well, he got down to shoot the damn ball. I was standing there with the booth. He stopped. He turned around and looked at me. I said, so what's wrong with you? I said, is this ball in you? He shook his damn head. He got down there with the fireball straight in. I got that ball from the pocket. I don't know what the fuck. I run that rack out, beat him. Then I broke it on the next rack out, beat him on the hill. And he went to victory. I said, Mary, I said, look, and I apologize for what I've done, but when he said it bothered him, I said, well, I'm sorry. I said, I didn't do this. I said, I was just over here beating up the balls around. And you know, that's the biggest hustle in the world, the biggest shark in the world to get up there and play on the other table. I said, fuck, I wasn't hitting no balls. I said, I'm rolling the ball. I said, I wasn't doing that to try to distract your game or anything. I was not doing it when you were shooting. And I apologize for it. Well, when he got down there to rack the balls, he racked the damn balls up. And then he had a couple of things. Steady talking. And he knew what he'd done. He took 220 by 10 out of his pocket. And walked it back to the pitcher and walked it up in. The 10 ball went to the side pocket. I mean, the 10 spot went to the side pocket. So I walked over there and I got the 220s and I stacked them up. I reached inside there. It didn't say nothing to him. I knew it was too far. Picked the 10 up. I put it in my hand. About the time I put it in my hand, he went off. You know that's the biggest shark in the world. You didn't do that. Nothing was perfect. And I said, first of all, I said, I don't have to do this to beat you. I can beat you in the perfect. I said, second of all, if this goddamn $50 is that important to me, I'm going to throw you right there in the face. It's like it just runs off of him like water off a dust back, but it made me so mad I'm ready to fight. Yeah, call me a cheater, it's what it was. If you got cheap, man, win. I, you know, I went off. I know Rick gets $50. He told me he'd give it around my damn car company or something. I might get blind. So what happened? He had shoulder surgery. He had some kind of shoulder surgery. They put him on a crutch stool. You don't think that might make a man's personality, his attitude change? You ain't got to go around like a crutch stool. He was taking them every day. Supposed to help heal that shoulder and all that kind of stuff. He was just as hungry as the son of a bitch he put up and get out of reach and out of beer. And he finally got off, he finally realized what he was doing. And he finally got off his insurance. And he changed a little bit, but damn, nobody, they would rather kiss Billy Sykes in the mouth than they had even saved it around Savannah or Statesman.
That is rough. I had a, I don't know how, I guess Billy got my number off on the flyers or something, and he was just messaging back and forth, and we know a mutual friend from Savannah. And I, you know this guy, you know, I'm stays cool, I've long been friends, you know, I thought they were closer friends than me. But Billy came best to me, he said, you still talking about something? So I messaged this guy, I said, did you really fall out? And he said, no, no, not at all. I said, maybe we'll just watch that talk to him. Just let you know. Give me a heads up. I mean, he has him like a dog. I think George won.
Huh? That's just the way it shows up. It shows up better on a phone.
I mean, we can, well, I think we can pull it out and you can see everybody, but you won't see the table.
Right.
I think Chris is talking about putting the camera on the wall, on the ceiling. Now you can know the words I'm using. That will look better. I'm going to put it there. Yes, it's much better on there. So that's the best part. That's the best part.
What time you be there? I'm going to go to the hospital.
with him.
I played so good in my first two matches. Didn't eat nothing. Well, I ate a solid basket on the way up there. Yeah, I
ate a solid basket on the way
up there.
That was my shot. I thought about scratching the ball.
I played the third match. My whole inside was shaking and shivering. I know what it had to be something with sugar. After I won the second night, I was doing the same thing. By the time I ordered, it took them about 30 minutes to get the food out. Then after I eat, about 20 minutes after I eat, he called me to play. So, then I was just the opposite. I used to eat like I did. But I'm going to have to just have to eat a bunch of this. I'm
also going to swing some diet.
That's what's going to stop me from having to do it.
It's what? You got it? What you got to score, Shaq?
I don't.
What? So everybody on the World Wide Web is screwed now. They made
all
lines.
Eight.
All eight of them. Yes.
All eight of them, yes. I'm going to have to go back and watch the video. I must have marked it wrong, but I got 4. I must have marked it wrong.
No, he went to the loser side. He's still like, that was 4 on the loser side. This is winner side.
I see you got three tonight, though.
See, if they do an fat ordinance that they got in Statesboro, there's a statewide ordinance. The same thing would apply right here for kids.
But he don't serve liquor. Do you serve liquor?
Yeah. Well, that's very true.
Well, I thought there's two different licenses. I thought there's two
different licenses. They are, but they say an alcohol.
That's Carl Gale in 60. Yeah, that's a solid straight. From here, I saw it.
I think it's going to be a lot of smoke. I'm trying to get it. And it's going to take somebody this long.
I think they can play now.
If you want them to.
They split them. No, they split. They split. I thought that was sick. They put them on every. You play the winner of Jim G and Stephen G.
Jim and Stephen G.
Between Jim G and Stephen G, you play the winner of those. No, we'll wait for the Mike Rogers and George. Yeah, thanks a lot, buddy.
Oh, man. Mike not only moved, he loved it too. I shot a ball and I messed up on a three ball right now. Shot the better. But we are stuck up a seal. You can't scale. You remember that?